when you don't know what the hell, you didn't watch the whole video.
What?
Shut your mouth about our people need us in Chicago. Do we not have a division called the Pull Up Boys?
Right.
Where brothers pull up to different incidents that happen? Shut your damn mouth. Don't lie against the truth. All right, what you got, all right? Bring it up.
Proverbs chapter 18, verse 13.
Good.
He that answer a matter before he hear it.
It said,
he that answer for matter before he hear it. Good. It is folly and shame unto him.
It becomes folly and shame unto you, man. You end up looking like a damn fool. So that's why the scriptures tell you, he that keepeth his mouth keepeth his life. Sometimes it's best to just shut the hell up if you don't know what you're talking about.
Right.
Stop the nonsense, man. This gospel is needed everywhere. It's needed everywhere. And if the Most High wanna have a celebrity speak about this truth, that's what the Most High can do. Give me Luke 15 and 11. Who the hell are you to say anything about somebody because somebody make a video talking about Ice Cube acknowledging the truth, or Carmelo Anthony, or Fantasia, or DeSean Jackson, or Nick Cannon? And Nick Cannon is old. That was a year ago with him and Professor Griff. So come on, man, knock it off. The Most High is doing that. He's using that to show his power through his word. Them dude, they may not wake up today or tomorrow, and you know, that's fine. All right, that's fine. But the Most High is showing you his power. Where even if they don't repent today or tomorrow, I can even make these celebrities acknowledge this truth. The hell out of here, man. This brother, now I could tell you endless stories, man. Endless stories of celebrities. Me and this brother and I have private conversations of all kinds of stuff the brother could tell you of celebrities knowing about this truth, man. You know what I'm saying? So just shut your damn, that's years ago. Just shut your damn mouth, you don't know nothing. All right, read what you got, brother.
It's the book of Luke, chapter 15 and verse 10.
And let me say this one thing too. Every celebrity ain't gonna come out and out like that. Then some of them will have to use discretion. Even the scriptures tell you that, the scriptures tell you about Nicodemus. He was a disciple of Yahushua, but secretly, because he was a Pharisee. He was up there and he had a top position in the Roman Empire as a Pharisee. So he was a follower of Yahushua in the cut. But guess what? He was a diehard follower. You don't know how the Most High gonna deal with people. So you can't say everybody's a sellout. Oh, that nigga need to be in the camp. He ain't really in the truth if he ain't in the camp. You can't say that. Because some people the Most High might deal with on different levels. It can be people die hard in this truth, but they can't come out right now because of contracts or certain things. But they keep the commandments. You don't know if they secretly supporting. Nigga, your ass ain't did nothing for the nation. That person could be donating everything under anonymous name. And your ass ain't gave a penny. You ain't brought a bag of potato chips to a damn feast day. And you ain't bring a bottle of water to a damn feast day, but you running your mouth. How you know that celebrity might be supporting on a loan or whatever? Yo, I gotta do this on a loan because you know my accountants, whatever, but you don't know. So, and the Most High dealing with everybody on different levels, man. So just shut your damn mouth. All right, God, brother.
Luke chapter 15 verse 10. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repents.
So you'll never know, man. It's joy in the presence of the angels of the Lord over one sinner that repent. Give me the other classic. Give me Joel 2:27. We always bring this one out too. You don't know who the Most High gonna put the spirit on, man. So that's all we say. You know, saying whether Ice Cube wearing fringes today or tomorrow or in a camp or whatever, but the man did acknowledge that we the real Hebrews. You know, sometimes these brothers they get a spirit on them. They say what they say for the moment. Then maybe their publicist or something might come and be like, well, you know, if you want to believe in that, just you know, just be cool. You know, don't come out so much. You know, you never know. And they just be in the cut. You know, acknowledging the truth. You never know. They're no different from somebody that is keeping a Sabbath, keeping the commandments in their home. They just don't have a congregation in their city. They're no different. So chill out, Israel. Chill out. You don't know how the Most High dealing with everybody on different levels. Who he gonna have? Now, we know some people are just BSing and not doing the work. But then the Most High gonna deal with everybody on different levels. All right, don't be so quick to open your damn mouth and look like where we read in Proverbs, and you be found shame, man, shameful in your talk. All right, read what you got, brother.
Joel chapter 2:27.
Come on.
And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
You're gonna know that I'm in the midst of Israel. The Lord said, in a place where it was said, ye are not my people, there should be said, you're the sons of the living power. So he gonna even make that come through celebrities. Are you limiting the power of the Most High? Right, come on.
And that I am the Lord your God and none else.
That what? I am the Lord your God and none else. Come on.
And my people shall never be ashamed.
The Lord said, my people shall never be ashamed. What about the football player that wears his fringes?
Come on.
What about the sister that was in the Olympics that was acknowledging she was a Hebrew?
Gabby Day.
You gonna talk about them too?
Yeah.
Hey, shut the hell up, man. You Negroes are simple. Go ahead.
And that
brother wears his fringes.
Right, yeah.
Actively in there. Right. So what you gonna say about that? All right, come on.
Verse 28, and it shall come to pass afterwards that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh.
The Lord said, guess what? He gonna pour out his spirit upon all flesh. All right, come on.
And on your sons and on your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams.
Your son and daughters gonna prophesy. Your old men are gonna dream dreams.
Right.
All right, come on.
Your young men shall see vision.
Go ahead.
And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids. In those days will I pour out my spirit. Verse 30. And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth.
The Lord said he's going to show wonders in heaven and in the earth. Come on.
And in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. Verse 31. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and the terrible day of the Lord come.
See that? The Lord said that it's going to be turned into darkness and the moon and the blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come. But he said he's going to pour his spirit upon all flesh. So everybody going to be acknowledging the truth on different levels in that day.
Right.
What happened when his system started falling apart and the mass media and the people have no choice but to come to us for answers?
Right.
All right, what happens in that day?
Sure.
What happens when the reporters are coming to us and say, so you guys are, you're really the Jews and Israelites?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What happened when the Most High break this place down so much they ain't got a choice but to hear us out?
Right.
Right.
You're going to have some catfish mouth Negro get mad in that day,
right,
and say, you talking about celebrities coming into the queue. Chicago needs us. Come on, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm tired, man. I've been holding my peace, man, but the gloves is about to be off on some of these catfish mouth niggas. Because niggas think they could just keep talking and lying on you, and I ignore it. I don't say nothing. My name keep coming up. Niggas keep slandering, lying, to the point where brothers be believing it. And I'm just sitting there like, if I take the gloves off on these catfish ass niggas, man, you know what I'm saying? But you try to stay in the spirit and not entertain the folly and deal with the seriousness of the work.
Right.
But I'm tired of these niggas running their mouth, man, and lying like hell and just saying anything out of their mouth to try to make you look bad. I read what you got, brother.
It's the book of Romans, chapter 11 and verse 3.
Come on.
Lord, they have killed thy prophets and digged down thine altars.
Come on.
I am left alone.
Good.
And they seek my life.
Yeah, see that? They seek your life, man. God, they want to destroy you. Come on.
But what saith the answer of God unto him?
Come on.
I have reserved to myself 7,000 men.
7,000 represents completion. The Lord said, look, I reserve a certain amount of men. All right, come on.
7,000 men who have not bowed the knee to the image of Baal.
Not bow the knee to the image of Baal. The Lord said, I got a complete set of men that's going to be for this truth, that's going to wake up, they're going to rise up, and no matter what happens, they're going to stay firm for the word of the Lord. God.
Even so then, at this present time also, there is a remnant according to the election of grace.
The Lord said, even at this present time, there's still, even at this present time, there's a remnant according to the election of grace. All right, go ahead.
And if by grace, then is it no more works? Otherwise, grace is no more grace.
The Lord said, if by grace it is no more works, otherwise grace is no more grace. Come on.
But if it be of works, then is it no more grace? Otherwise, work is no more work.
So the basic of the Lord is letting us know he's got a remnant of men that he saved. So we don't really want to like get into that folly, man, and that negativity. But it's just, come on, Israel. It's just, the moral of the story is late in the game. Let's stop the F-boy-ish and let's do some real men work.
Right.
All right, I ain't gonna curse, but let's get off the F-boy-ish, man, and let's do some real work, man. Come on, if you're a true man of the Lord, let's get down to business and do some real work. And get off the F-boy stuff, man. All right, come on, it's more than that.
Verse 7. What then? Israel have not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded.
Go, man, the election is going to obtain it, and the rest will be blinded. See, I even said, I got to go back to it. Even when the COVID started, I said, listen, when the Most High start turning this thing up and bringing certain prophecies, even some of Israel in the truth not going to be able to handle it, man. Their spirit short circuit. Now all these celebrities acknowledging the truth, niggas got a problem with that. See, your spirit can't handle it. You can't understand Joel 2. You can't understand the prophecy in Joel 2, so your spirit short circuit. Because celebrities, back-to-back celebrities are acknowledging the truth, so niggas can't handle it.
Right.
Niggas can't handle it. See, you give me a Revelation 3 and 15. I'm going to show you what Christ said about you, man. You got one foot in and one foot out.
Right.
All right, you're dealing with what I call the showmanship of this truth. You're dealing with the showmanship. You're happy to be here. You're an Israelite. You're wearing your fringes. You're on social media. You're prophesying. The Most High bringing the people to you. But with some real, when it get down to the nitty gritty and real prophecy start happening, you can't handle it. You're like I said, your spirit, you get a damn shortage in your wire. Your spirit short circuit. You can't handle when the Most High start to bring the real. All right, so read what you got, brother.
This is Revelation chapter 3, verse 15. I know thy work.
Yahweh said, I know your works. Come on.
That thou art neither cold nor hot.
That's cold within itself. Yahweh said, a lot of y'all not cold or hot, man. Yahweh stepping with this truth. All right, come on.
I would not thou were cold or hot.
He said, I want you to either be cold or hot. All right, come on.
So then, because thou art lukewarm.
See that? You got to ask yourself a question. Am I a lukewarm Israelite? When these prophecies really start to happen, could I take it? Could I handle it? All right, come on.
And neither cold nor hot.
Because you are lukewarm and you're neither cold nor hot. Go ahead.
I will spew thee out of my mouth.
Listen, a lot of you, I'll spew you out of my mouth, man. Because you can't take it because there's 100 shootings in Chicago. That's prophecy. The Lord said death shall be chosen rather than life. The Lord said... that in Leviticus 26, the curse was that we would be slain before our enemies.
Right.
In Amos, we just read it in Amos, it said you would die in your enemy's land. You would die in a polluted land. But 99 shootings happened in Chicago, and a nigga that's supposed to be in the truth, that's supposed to understand the scriptures, his spirit get cut short. He can't handle it. Oh, 99 people died. Well, who died? Why that happened? Because your spirit got cut short. You can't handle what the Most High is doing. But that's how people are. What you got? Bring it up.
It's the book of Sirach, chapter 2 and verse 12. Woe be to the fearful hearts and fainting hands and the sinner that goeth two ways.
It said, woe be to fearful hearts and the faint hands and the sinner that go two ways. Come on.
Woe unto him that is faint hearted. For he believeth not.
He said, woe to him that's faint-hearted because he don't believe. The spirit cannot handle when the Lord start to bring certain things down. Even, you can't even handle when celebrities acknowledge the truth. You got to have a problem with that. All right, one brother straight up called Ice Cube a faggot. Damn faggot. Before he come in the truth, he got to stop. Now, I ain't never heard no homo stuff about Ice Cube. Now, he might have sold his soul to Hollywood, whatever the case may be. But I've never heard, that's one brother I've never heard nothing about. I never even seen a conspiracy video about him. You know, even I don't even think they butt broke him in a movie. He ain't never put on no dress or nothing. You know what I'm saying? But come on, you know, this nigga's a faggot. He ain't a, come on, brother. You know what I'm saying? they can't accept the truth, man.
The angry Israelites.
Angry Israelites, man. Oh, Ice Cube. Ice Cube ain't in the truth. That nigga's a fag. He got to repent and stop being a faggot. I ain't never heard nothing about Ice Cube being a homo. Now, like I said, that's Hollywood, and some of them hide their stuff more than others. I don't know what Cube done did in a dark room.
Right.
I'm not going to even say he never did. But they just, you just so angry because a famous person acknowledged the truth. That's what? Your spirit short circuit. That means you don't believe in the Most High where he said he gonna pour his spirit upon all flesh. You don't even believe in the Most High when he say that. Alright, come on.
Woe to him that is faint hearted, for he believeth not. Therefore shall he not be defended.
Said in that day you're not gonna be defended. So you know, come on, Israel, man. You know the Most High got the power to do anything. That's all I'm saying. Whoever is meant to come into this thing, they gonna come into this thing. I don't care if they famous or not. I don't care if they're a bum off the street or the top paid Negro in America. Whoever the Most High gonna wake up. You know what I'm saying? Whoever the Most High gonna wake up. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, let's stop looking for excuses to hate each other, Israel. It's over. The curses should be, or the curses, it's over. It's time to go home. It's time to get the hell out of this captivity. Yes, we're gonna suffer, you know. When I say the curses is over, meaning it's time to come out of them. It's start to lift them. It's time to come into the truth. Especially if you're in this truth, that stuff's supposed to be lifting up off of you. That stuff's supposed to be coming off of you, man. You Negroes still sitting there with the hatred and the malice and the low frequency behavior. That damn low frequency behavior, that self-hating Negro, cotton-filled, house nigga, field nigga mentality, man. The house nigga is mad at the field nigga. The field nigga is mad at the house nigga. And we all niggas at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, let's just repent and keep these commandments and come back and let's do some serious work.